السلام عليكم ورحمة الله بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد All thanks and praise are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala And may his peace and blessings be upon his last and final messenger, his family, his companions And those who follow them until the end of times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah At-Taghabun فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ Be mindful of Allah Be conscious of Allah Beware of Allah as much as you can. Now this is a very important principle, a very practical principle that plays an important role in our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we are supposed to be mindful, conscious, and aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of our abilities. We are supposed to try our best to obey His commandments and stay away from His prohibitions. We're supposed to put forward an honest effort. And that is because we as human beings are not expected to be perfect. Perfection is an attribute that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us as human beings with certain weaknesses, certain inabilities. And that is one of the reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not burden an individual with more than they can bear. لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not obligate an individual beyond what they can handle. And that is a very, very important point for us to realize. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ Allah wants ease for you, not hardship. Similarly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, أَدِينُ يُسْرٌ That truly the religion is ease. Now ease is a very subjective term. Because what is easy for one person may be very difficult for another. And what is difficult for one person may be very easy for someone else. So it's really important for us to understand what does it mean when the Prophet ﷺ says, أَدِينُ يُسْرٌ That religion is easy. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants ease for you. So what is meant by ease is that every human being has the ability to follow the teachings of Islam by trying their best to obey the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay away from His prohibitions. Meaning every single one of us, you and I, have the internal strength, have the ability, have the capability to live our lives according to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by putting forth our best effort, by trying, by struggling, by putting in work. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told his companions, مَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَاجْتَنِبُوا That what I have forbidden you to do, avoid it, stay away from it. وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَأْتُوا مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ And what I have ordered you to do, what I have commanded you to do, then do as much as you can. So the Prophet ﷺ, right, he's telling the companions radiallahu anhum that when it comes to prohibitions, avoid them. Stay away from them. And when it comes to the commandments, then try your best. فَأْتُوا مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ Right, do as much as possible. And the Prophet ﷺ is telling the companions to give their best effort. And there is extremely deep wisdom in this statement. Right? The Prophet ﷺ is recognizing that human beings are weak by nature and they will not be able to fulfill every single command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor are they required to. What they are required to do is put forth their best effort, to try honestly, to be real and honest with ourselves, that we are giving 100%. The Prophet ﷺ told us that أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّكُمْ لَن تُطِيقُوا أَوْ لَن تَفْعَلُوا كُلَّ مَا أُمِرْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَكِنْ سَدِّدُوا وَقَارِبُوا He said, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ O people, إِنَّكُمْ لَن تُطِيقُوا You will never be able to. Or he said, لَن تَفْعَلُوا You will never do كُلَّ مَا أُمِرْتُمْ بِهِ Everything you have been commanded to do. وَلَكِنْ سَدِّدُوا But get as close as possible. Try your best. وَأَبْشِرُوا And seek glad tidings. that as long as we're being real with ourselves, as long as we're being honest with ourselves, and we're putting forth this honest effort, saddidu, right? We're trying our best to get as close as possible, then the Prophet says, abshiru. Then seek glad tidings of forgiveness and grace and mercy, forgiveness from your Lord. Right? The Prophet ﷺ says, inna ad-deena yusrun, that truly the religion is easy. وَلَنْ يُشَادَ الدِّينَ إِلَّا غَلَبَهُ. One who imposes upon himself undue hardship in religious matters, they will overwhelm him. Whoever tries to become excessive, whoever becomes extreme, and they start doing things that are not required of them, they start burdening themselves with more than they can handle. Right? إِلَّا غَلَبَهُ. It will overwhelm them. So the Prophet says, فَسَدِّدُوا. Follow a middle path. Be balanced, be moderate. Now, that means you have to do all your obligations, but when it comes to voluntary things, when it comes to extra credit, when it comes to doing things to get even closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saddidu, right? Follow a middle path, be balanced, be moderate. وَقَارِبُ, get as close as you can. وَأَبِشِرُ, and then rejoice over the reward of your good deeds. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالْغَضْوَ وَالرَّوْحَ وَشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الدُّلْجَ, and seek to utilize a portion of the morning and evening and the latter part of the night in worship. So this is a very important principle, a very practical principle that we can apply to our everyday lives. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ, that it is our responsibility to be mindful, to be conscious, to be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as we can, to the best of our abilities. And if we try our best, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. He is the most merciful, the very merciful. He is Al-Ghafoor and the most forgiving. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us taqwa. Wa salli Allahumma ala nabiyyina maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.